I produced a novel with an exegesis.
I produced a series of ceramic figurative sculptures.
It was a CD of original music in which I mashed up political speech.
I produced a creative work which was an audiovisual performance piece that saw five musicians accompanied by a VJ.
I produced a live public performance.
I see myself as a hybrid ethnomusicologist and music performer.
I'm represented by Waters Gallery in Sydney, where I've been showing for a few years.
Well, the crime novel was published by New Holland Publishing.
I started using paper and pencils and a lot of traditional drawing tools, and through the master's research began to expand my drawing into more of a performative element. The development of the master's program for me significantly introduced me to electronic projections as a part of my performance drawing work.
So my supervisors were really invaluable in helping me to bridge that gap between being a musical artist and an academic.
You know, we talk, we devise projects together, we get excited about things, there's a sort of honest exchange.
I was able to connect with a fantastic network of musicians.
I was born locally, so I came back to the area because of family. So I decided to take up, you know, postgraduate kind of research then.
I find small towns quite creative places and allow you to spend a lot of time being creative and doing hands-on stuff rather than sitting in traffic jams.
It's a very physically beautiful region, which I personally find very inspiring.
Living with amongst people who are interested in so many different things, your creative impulse juices, if you like, get flowing.
So I found that SCU's, or my studies here at SCU, enabled me to take a great leap forward, I suppose, in my own career aspirations.